Hey, welcome back to part two. First part, we did a little tutorial and all that. Sorry if you hear my headset. So yeah, we did the tutorial, did a kind of an intro thingy. I do have to tell you something. I changed the language back to English. I played a bit in English, like the first part, and a little bit further than this. Sorry that I didn't really think about it, because I looked back at part one, and I think for a let's play purpose it's a bit better to use English voices, unless everyone wants it to be English, sorry, Japanese, because if you're just, you know, turning on the video on your second screen or something, or you just want to relax and not, you know, really concentrate that much, having Japanese voice, you have to constantly read the subtitles. So I changed it back, play a few minutes more. I'll tell you exactly where everything will be blind. It's such a little part that I don't think it really mattered, but I do have to let you know it's no longer Japanese unless you really, really want it to. And yeah, so let's get started. Enough of the talking. Probably put a skip button in the beginning if you want to skip it. It's okay, so welcome. Let's see. Head to your new lodging, exit the subway station. Let's go. I do like the loading screens. Like, I think it's pretty cool. Okay, starting today, Sojiro Sakura will be taking care of me. His house should be in the back streets of this residential area. Okay, that's not good. Little shock very slow. Tutorial. Daily life. Talking to people. All sorts of people live in the city. Try listening to their conversations or press the X button to talk to them. You might learn something new. Yeah, this is the street apparently where we'll live. There's the map. Bottom right. So I talk to these people. Yes. So again, make choices. I can't remember if the other Persona games did the same. I want to ask for directions. You want to get to the residence at the address? It's in an alley a bit further back. Take a right after the apartment with the stairs. So I was just walking around. You can see that there's shops all over, but when you try to interact, it keeps saying that the owner is not here and that we'll have to come back later and all that. But looking at the map, there's a lot going on, so let's walk over here. It's at the alley with the stairs. Dog loving girl. Was there another accident? I see a policeman over there. A gentle looking mother, okay. Oh, he's just watching to make sure everyone's safe. It'd be scary if something like that happened again, though. Let's hurry home. Something like what happened again? Okay, I remember going here. Sojiro Sakura's house. The nameplate here says Sakura. It looks like this might be Sojiro Sakura's house. Even after ringing the doorbell, it doesn't look like anyone will answer the door. Maybe he's gone out. Parcel delivery man. It looks like no one's home. Oh yeah, Sakura-san's usually at his cafe around this time. While LeBlanc in the back alley, so... LeBlanc's in the back alley, so I should make my other deliveries first. Next I need to take this package too. Alright. Back alley, so it took me a little bit to find it the first time. We were almost at the part that it's completely blind. And it's over here, yes. Okay. So this is the cafe. It looks like this place is LeBlanc. I'll go inside.
transit bus was driven down an opposing lane with its customers still in it. The citizens can't live in peace if this keeps up.
Oh, how frightening.
What could be going on? Didn't something similar happen just the other day?
Vertical is the name of a shellfish used for farming pearls. Oh, right. They did say that was today.
We'll be going now. The payment's on the table.
Thanks for coming.
This place is in the back alley, so there's no worries of a car crashing in here.
A what now?
There's been a string of those rampage accidents, you know. I just hope that none happen around here.
It's none of my concern.
We'll see you next time.
Four hours for just a single cup of Joe. So, you're the guy.
I'm the guy. Well, let's just be polite. This is the thing I did before.
Yeah. I'm Sojiro Sakura. You'll be in my custody over the next year. I was wondering what kind of unruly kid would show up. But you're the one, huh? Have you been told? A customer of mine and your parents know each other, and, well, not that that matters. Follow me.
All right.
This is your room.
Nice room.
I'll at least give you sheets for your bed. You look like you want to say something.
So I'll just make the same choice, because... wanted to be polite. They can't really say it's cluttered. Like, at least he takes care of us, right? So, it's big. Big room.
It's on you to clean up the rest. I'll be leaving after I lock up each day. You'll be alone at night, but don't do anything stupid.
I was reading.
Now then.
Okay.
I got the gist of your situation. You protected some woman from a man forcing himself on her. He got injured, then sued you, right? That's what you get for sticking your nose in a matter between two adults. You did injure him, yeah? And now that you've got a criminal record, you were expelled from your high school. The courts ordered you to transfer and move out here, which your parents also approved. In other words, they got rid of you for being a pain in the ass. It's best you not talk about anything unnecessary. I am in the restaurant business, you know. Behave yourself for the year. If nothing happens, your probation will be lifted.
Okay, probation?
Really now? It's the word that applies to you. Your sentence lasts until next spring, right? That's why you're gonna be here for the coming year. Cause any problems and you'll be sent straight to juvie. We'll be going to Shujin tomorrow.
Shujin?
Shujin Academy, the school you'll be attending. We'll introduce ourselves properly to the staff there. There's rarely a place to accept someone like you, you know? What a waste of my Sunday.
Well, sorry.
Your luggage arrived earlier.
All right. Very close to the point. I don't know what's going on. I'll be living here starting today. I should check out what's in here. Right. It's the cardboard box sent from back home. It's full of clothes and daily necessities. I'll change into more comfortable clothes for now. Alright. I guess I should clean the room while I'm organizing things. Okay. There's a mattress here. Is this supposed to be my bed? Well, it looks really bad. It's a desk with a stack of books on top. No one can use this as a desk while it's like this. True. I should start cleaning first. Start cleaning. Man, that bat looks bad. Okay, evening. It's late. It seems like I've been cleaning for a while.
Seriously?
Okay, what the heck? I heard you're making all sorts of noise up here, but I didn't think you were cleaning. Actually, the place doesn't look too bad. Though it's only natural you'd want to keep your room tidy. Why don't you go to bed for tonight? You don't have anything better to be doing, right? Well, I don't know. I'm going to close up shop and get out of here myself.
I'm gonna head back then.
I won't be the one looking after you if you get sick from staying up too late. You got that? Sure. Okay. Sleeping in your bed will move you forward one day. Alright. And daily life tutorial. How to advance time. Going to bed is a special action that will advance time. Time is limited. Think carefully about your schedule before you act. Okay. Available addict. Attic. Sorry. So it's been cleaned, so no people can see. Okay, so this is where everything will be blind. That's all I did. But I just thought you at least, you know, should know that I played in English and, you know, I just thought it would be better for Let's Play. Okay, so said that I needed to sleep to advance the time. Alright. Starting today, this is my room. Change and go to sleep. Arrest, trial, criminal record.
Damn brat! I'll sue!
Still, I couldn't just let that go. Well, it's pretty bad. Getting sued for, you know, protecting a woman. That day, I had to go home early. Okay, so. Dreaming about it? What happens if I go back here? Damn it. My house isn't this way. I should hurry home. Alright.
Just get in the car.
Alright.
Stop it!
Is it down there? I can hear a man and a woman arguing in the distance. I think they're just up ahead. Let's go. I just don't want to rush him. Maybe he says something. Or
no.
Okay, struggling woman.
Don't give me that shit.
Drunk man. It looks like the drunk man is bothering that woman.
Help! Please stop.
She's in danger. Well, I have to save her. That's the right thing to do. So.
Of time. You think you're worth causing me trouble, huh?
I'll call the police!
Call them if you want. The police are my bitches. They're not gonna take you seriously.
No! Stop!
Someone called the cops, huh? Get in the car! Incompetent fools like you just need to shut your mouths and follow where I steer this country. What are you looking at? Get out of my face! This ain't a show. You're lost, kid. See? This is all because you're so damn slow. Get in the car!
Alright. It's that weird app that somehow ended up on my phone. The icon looks almost like an eye. I thought I deleted it. My eyelids are starting to get heavy. really need to charge my controller.
Trickster, welcome to my velvet room.
Damn, I knew it was the velvet room. It's from the other personas, too.
So you've come too, inmate. The you in reality is currently fast asleep. You are only experiencing this as a dream.
You're in the presence of our master. Stand up straight!
Welcome. I am delighted to make your acquaintance. This place exists between dream and reality, mind and matter. It is a room that only those who are bound by a contract may enter. I am Igor, the master of this place. Remember it well. I summoned you to speak of important matters. It involves your life as well.
Okay, important matters?
Still, this is a surprise. The state of this room reflects the state of your own heart. To think a prison would appear as such. You truly are a prisoner of fate. In the near future, there is no mistake that ruin awaits you.
Ruin?
I speak of the end to everything. However, there is a means to oppose such a fate. You must be rehabilitated. Rehabilitated toward freedom. That is your only means to avoid ruin. Do you have the resolve to challenge the distortion of the world?
Of course. Yeah, I'd rather avoid ruin.
Allow me to observe the path of your rehabilitation. Ah, pardon me for not introducing the others. To your right is Caroline. To your left, Justine. They serve as wardens here.
Ha! Try and struggle as hard as you like!
The duty of wardens is to protect inmates. We are also your collaborators. That is, if you remain obedient.
I shall explain the roles of these two at another occasion.
Interesting.
Now then, it seems the night is waning. It is almost time. Take your time to slowly come to understand this place. We will surely meet again, eventually.
Time's up! Now hurry up and go back to sleep!
Okay. Sunday the 10th, okay, I had a strange dream. Ruin, rehabilitation. What does it mean?
Hey.
Looks like you're up. Nice hat. Well then, let's go introduce ourselves properly to the staff about your transfer. The school you're attending is in the Aoyama district. It'll cost you a bit to ride the train there, and the route transfers are a pain. Route route. I'll drive you there, but just for today. Let's go. Alright.
Jeez,
men aren't usually allowed in my passenger seat. Well, hold on.
Do me a favor and behave yourself, all right?
Sure.
Don't get me wrong. I don't care what happens to you. Just don't cause me any trouble.
To reiterate, just so we're clear, you will immediately be expelled if you cause any problems. Honestly, I hesitated on accepting someone like you, but there were some circumstances on our side. You might have done a variety of things in hiding in your hometown, but you will behave yourself here. If you are thrown out from our school, there will be no place for you to go. Keep that in mind. This is the teacher in charge of your class.
I'm Sadayo Kawakami.
Okay, difficult name.
Here's your student ID. Be sure to read the school rules. Any violations will send you straight to the guidance office. And if by chance you cause any problems, I won't be able to protect you at all. That is your promise, yes, Principal Kobayakawa?
Kobayakawa.
Mm-hmm. He is responsible for all his actions.
But really, though, why me? There should have been better candidates.
It was a sudden transfer, and your class was the only one that had an opening.
If you're done explaining things, mind if we get going? I got a store to get back to.
Sakura-san, please keep a close eye on him. Don't let him cause any trouble outside.
Well, I'll be sure to have a serious talk about the situation he's in.
Come to the faculty office when you arrive at school tomorrow. I'll show you to your classroom.
Why is everyone acting so bad against me? Damn. They're treating you like some kind of nuisance. I guess that's what it means to have a criminal record, but man, it's not even like something bad. Turns out your past follows you wherever you go. By the way, if you get expelled now, I won't hesitate to kick you out. Got it? Yeah, I'll be careful, sure. School never changes, huh?
Hey!
Come on, we're going home. Let's go.
What a troublesome situation.
Jersey wearing teacher.
I can't believe they pushed someone with a record on me. A male teacher would be better suited for this.
Why in the world was someone like that admitted here?
Who knows? It was the principal's decision. I was told that it's for the school's reputation.
I would have thought that my volleyball team has contributed more than enough to cover that.
That's certainly true.
Be careful, okay? Then again, if anything were to happen, I'd kick out a student like that right away.
Well, I keep wishing that he'd just end up not coming to school. Still, that isn't something I should be saying as a teacher.
Well, I should be returning to practice.
Oh, right. The tournament's coming up, isn't it?
Having such high expectations placed on you by others is quite a problem in itself. We'll have to work hard to make up for the track team, too.
Yes, that's true. Why'd it have to be my class?
Why is everyone such an asshole? Damn it.
Oh, traffic's not moving at all. You're taking the train starting tomorrow.
Sure.
So, how was it? The school, I mean. Think you can manage?
Well. Boy, it'll be tough, though.
You brought it on yourself, though.
Nah.
Still, you were expelled once already. To think you'd re-enroll at a different one. It's not like anyone will be sympathetic with you. That's what it was like at school. People might say stuff about me in the future, too. What a troublesome kid I've taken in.
Yeah, why did you take me?
I was asked to do it, and I just happened to agree to it. I've already been paid for it, too, after all.
Again, a subway has derailed at Shibuya Station, greatly affecting the timetable all across the...
Derail, yeah.
Oh, another accident. So that's why it's so crowded. There's been a lot of those lately.
From the accident. According to the police, the engineer's life was not in danger despite his injuries. After questioning, even he could not explain his high speed when approaching the station. No further comments were made. Police are still looking for a plausible motive.
It's less of an operating accident and more of a crime of the company and the government. Site inspectors apparently reported all of this 6 months ago. The deterioration of the tracks and the ATC. Seems a railway company and the Ministry of Transport both turned a blind eye to the truth. There's no way they can hide. This will go all the way to the top.
Now on to our main story. With this derailment accident, as well as other recent incidents of unknown motive, concern is spreading among the general public. Just what could be causing such a drastic change so suddenly in these people? SNN has...
Everything's linked. That's what you're thinking, correct? Oh well. Are you free? You and I haven't gone for a drink in a while.
Thank you, sir. But I have another meeting to attend. I must be going.
I was ready to go for this meeting, and that's when this extremely fast train just came crashing in. Oh man, I thought I was gonna die.
A noisy subway platform filled with people.
Did you ask for me? Is it a case?
Not quite. I want your opinion on something.
Sure. Your judgment is quite often correct, though. Can we discuss this over sushi, perhaps? You are making a student work late, after all.
Conveyor belt only.
Aww. Okay. Damn, to think there'd be that much traffic. What a waste of time. I wasn't able to open the cafe today.
Well,
whatever.
Fine.
Just head upstairs. There's something I need to give to you. Money? Please. Need to take the train now, so.
Talk about a gruesome accident. 80 people were involved. It's a diary. Make sure you write in it.
Okay.
You may be under probation, but there's no special limitations on what you do in particular. Besides following the law, that is. However, I'm obligated to report on you, which is why I'm having you record your daily activities.
Alright.
Hey, what's up? I'm about to leave right now. Don't worry. I'll be there in no time. I'll see you soon. Well, I'm off. I'll lock the place up. So do whatever you want for the rest of the night. Oh, but don't mess up my store. If something goes missing, I'll hand you right over to the cops. You got school tomorrow. You better head off to bed, all right?
Sure. Okay, a diary. I should do as I'm told for now. Not sure what the diary is for exactly, for gameplay mechanics. Let's see, I should write down what happened today in my diary. Alright. You can save your game by pressing the options button. When you see the button command in the lower left, you can save at any time. Alright. I have an early day tomorrow, I should rest up. So I can...
I should write something. Let's do it.
Alright, so, just gonna save. Say that already exists in the slum. Would you like that? Yeah, sure. Alright. And this one is not mine, it's my girlfriend's one, so. Nothing weird there. Alright. So I'll just quickly stop the recording and charge my controllers. I'll be right back for you. It's just like a second. So, be right back.